Hey guys, I'm Peyton with TigerStop, and today I'm going to show you how to scale your TigerStop. So before we begin, I'd like to explain to you how to recognize when we have a scale problem. So the common symptom of a scale problem is when the TigerStop is accurate at a position, but as we move to a shorter position or to a longer position with the TigerStop, it becomes more inaccurate. So here's how we test that. To start, we're going to send the TigerStop to a short position. So we'll go ahead and send it to 10, 10, and start. And we'll make a cut. And we'll measure this cut piece. Okay, so I can see I'm a little long. I'm about 10 and 1/32. So we're gonna need to calibrate it. So to calibrate it, we'll need to go into the menu. And it's going to ask us for the password. So we're going to need to get the password. It's likely going to be your serial number. The serial number can be found on the idle end of the TigerStop. So on the opposite end of the motor box, right on the front face of the extrusion. So we can see here, the serial number is 152-7331. So we'll go ahead and enter that in. 152-7331, and we're going to hit equals, and then we're going to select A for setup. Now the first option on the screen is going to be enter distance from zero, so we'll go ahead and enter it in on this screen. So we'll type in 10. We're going to use the right arrow button to create a space, 1/32. We'll hit equals to verify that it's changed, and then hit done. Now you'll notice on the screen, the position has now changed to 10 and 1/32. So now to check for the repeatability, we're gonna send the TigerStop out to a long position, and then we're gonna bring it back into 10 inches. So we'll go ahead and send it to 70 inches. And then we'll bring it back into 10 inches. And we'll make one more cut. We'll get one more measurement. Okay, I can see we're right on 10 inches. Okay, so now that we know that we're accurate at a close position, and we're also repeatable at that close position, we're now gonna send the TigerStop to a long position. So we're gonna go ahead and send it to 60 inches. And then we'll grab a longer stock piece and make a cut. And now we'll measure this piece. Okay, so I can see here I'm a little long. I'm at 60 3/16. So let's go ahead and see what our current scale is set to. So once again, we'll need to go into the menu. We'll use our serial number as the password. We're gonna select A for setup. And now we're gonna use the right arrow button and scroll through until we see the scale option. Okay, so we can see right now the scale is set to 2.36205. So we're going to take those three numbers and figure out what our new scale is going to be. So we'll take 60 divided by 60 3/16, multiplied by 2.36205. All right, so we can see our new scale is going to be 2.352. So let's go ahead and enter in our password. Hit equals. And then we'll enter in our new scale. And hit equals. We'll verify that it's changed. And then hit done. So if you find that the position on the screen does not match what you measured your long piece of material to be, you may need to repeat the process one more time. All right, guys, so that's how you scale your TigerStop. Once again, my name is Peyton, and thank you for watching this video, and thank you for choosing TigerStop. If you have any requests for any additional how-to videos, please leave a comment in the comment section below.